Hello everyone and welcome to today's video, which I know has taken quite some time to come out, but I'd like to switch gears to Street Fighter V and talk about Chun-Li. Specifically, we'll be doing a guide on how to get started with playing her. Okay, now this video is brought to you by the Chun-Li Discord. This is an effort that we decided to do so that new players would have a resource to look at so that they could get to know the character quickly. Special thanks to Ross, who provides a lot of the match footage that I'll be using throughout this guide to show you some examples of the things that we're talking about. So as I mentioned, this guide is specifically for beginners. Maybe you just picked up Street Fighter and Chun-Li stood out to you, or maybe you're fighting for silver and you like to get some tips on how to get there. So this will be covering the basics of the character and how to have a good baseline to develop with her. With that, let's keep the intro short and let's get started. Okay, the first thing I think we ought to do is talk about what kind of character Chun-Li is and her game plan. What does she want to do? Okay, Chun is focused on the neutral game. She's a very poke-heavy character, so she has good far-reaching buttons like standing hard punch, standing hard kick, and back forward medium punch. These normals, as you can see, they have a lot of range, so she's very good at poking. And to complement that, as you can see, she has very fast walk speed. Both her forward and back walk speed are very high. They're on the higher ends of the characters in the game. So her game plan is she wants to like navigate her way around the screen in a way that she can hit her enemy, but her enemy can't really hit her back. And when they're scared of pressing buttons because they're afraid of eating standing hard punches all day, that's when she can move in to get her pressure. Okay, so as I've mentioned, Chun-Li is centered around her pokes, and some of them I've already mentioned, so let's talk about them a bit more. So first up is standing hard punch. Now this is the Chun-Li classic. She almost always has this normal. Actually always, as far as I know. And as you can see, it has a lot of range and it's very annoying to deal with in the neutral. So what you want to do with this normal in general is harass your opponent with it and try to do it from max distance, because technically this move is unsafe and some things can punish it if you do it up close, like right here. So learn the spacing of this move and use it at the correct spacing. So at max distance, this is very good. Harass your opponent with it. Make them afraid to press their own buttons so that you can then move in. Now, while it's good to harass the opponent with standing hard punch, don't get too trigger happy with it. Try not to spam it. Because if you're doing it too much and the opponent notices this, they could do something to avoid, maybe if you're doing two in a row, they could avoid the second one and you might eat a lot of damage for it. So try to be more mindful of how you use this button even as you're harassing the opponent. So to demonstrate this, I've recorded Chun-Li to do two standing hard punches, one after the other. So as Kami, we are going to block the first one and see what we can do to avoid the second one and turn things in our favor. Okay, so you see that if Chun is doing two standing hard punches one after the other, the opponent has a chance to jump in on you. So as I mentioned, please be careful about how you're using it. It's good to use it, of course, but don't get spammy with it. Be deliberate in how you use it. Okay, next let's talk about back medium punch, which is this. Now, as you can see, the range isn't as high as standing hard punch. This normal, obviously, you'll want to use it when you're a bit closer to the opponent. Now, at this range, like I mentioned, you don't want to do standing hard punch. So, back medium punch is your alternative. So, if you're a bit closer to your opponent, but you still want to poke, this is very good. Okay, next, let's talk about standing hard kick. Now, this is Chan's longest reach in normal. But you want to be careful with how you use it and against which characters, because for one thing, it doesn't hit crouching opponents. So if you do this and they crouch it, you'll probably get punished. So this normal, it's very situational, and like I mentioned, it's good against certain characters. For example, against Zangief, this normal is very good. It'll help you a lot in that matchup. And recently, thanks to Naga in the Chun-Li Discord, we now know that this also is very helpful for fighting Karin. So just be aware of this normal for specific matchups, especially Zangief. Use this, it'll help you a lot. But otherwise, it's situational. Don't use it too much. Despite Chun-Li's normals being very strong, as you've seen at poking and harassing the enemy, we saw that there is a weakness to doing it too often, in that like Kami could just jump and punish her. So how do you deal with this? This is where anti-airs come into play. And it cannot be overstated how important anti-airs are. Please, you really need to learn how to anti-air well. It will save your life in this game, trust me. So let's take a look at Chun-Li's anti-airs. So first, let me give you a demonstration of how this would work, and then let's talk about the anti-airs. So this is going to be similar to the situation where Kami blocks a standing hard punch, then she jumps to avoid the second one. But Chun-Li anticipates this and anti-airs her. So let's see what that looks like. As you've seen there, with an anti-air, Chun-Li is able to keep Kami from getting in on her. And this is essentially how you win the neutral. You harass your opponent with your long-reaching normals, enough to frustrate them into maybe jumping or doing something unsafe, and then you respond to that. So if you're able to do it well enough, you'll have them feeling like there's not a lot they can do about it, in a sense. This type of play is designed to demoralize your opponent. So, get your ground normals. Learn how to use them well, like a Chun-Li standing hard punch and such, and be ready for when the opponent jumps or tries to do something unsafe to get in on you and punish them for it. So now let's look at all of Chun-Li's best anti-air options. I'll tell you the advantages and disadvantages to each. Okay, the first anti-air we're going to talk about is back hard kick, which I've just demonstrated. Now this is Chun-Li's best normal anti-air. You really need to get familiar with how to use it as quickly as you can. It's very good because it has good vertical range. The horizontal range is a bit limited, but it can also hit cross-up. So if the opponent tries to cross you up, this will beat them. Now, another reason why this anti-air is good is that it puts Chun-Li in a very favorable position. So let me show you what I mean by that. Okay, now you see that. After anti-airing Kami, Chun is able to dash and get on the other side of her. So this creates a situation where Kami now has to kind of decide or guess what whether Chan will remain on one side or dash under her to the other side. So yeah, back hard kick is a very good anti-air. Please practice how to use it. Okay, the next anti-air we'll look at is EX Bird Kick. Now, I'll tell you more about her specials later on, but for now, let's just look at how this move works as an anti-air. So again, I'll have Kami jump at me and let's see what happens. Okay, as you've seen, Kami's jumping attack gets beaten. This is a very reliable anti-air because it's invincible, so it'll beat any normal that comes into contact with it. But of course, there are two catches. One, you can see I'm crouching. You have to charge this move. I'm sure you know that as a Chun-Li player, that she has specials that she has to charge. And second, it'll cost you a bar of meter. So yeah, keep those two things in mind. Okay, the last anti-air we'll talk about is Standing Light Kick, which is this. Now, the biggest advantage of this is that, number one, it's easy to do. It's just pressing a single button, and it's also very fast. But you kind of have to be on point to use this as an anti-air reliably, because it trades a lot, and sometimes it's even beaten by some jump-ins. But because of its speed, if you're able to master how to use it, it'll be very useful to you. So let's have Kami jump at us and see how it fares against her jumping hard kick. So you see that, very simple to do, it's very fast. But it doesn't get you a lot. It's not like a back hard kick where, you know, you can get the dash under and things like that. It's very simple. The best reward that it gives you is that it gets the opponent a bit away from you, so that you can go back to your standing hard punch, back medium punch and such. So yeah, but if you can master how to use it and when to use it against some characters and against some jump-ins, it's very reliable because it's fast, so you are unlikely to be too late to react to the opponent's jump. Okay, let's look at her special moves, and let's start with lightning legs. You do this with quarter circle forward and kick. Now, you can also do it by mashing a kick button, but please, I would recommend you avoid doing this at all. The reason is because you will often get it out by accident, maybe if you're trying to interrupt the opponent with crouching light kick or something. So if you're mashing on crouching light kick, whether or not you want it, the legs will come out. And this move is unsafe, so what that means is that if it's blocked, your opponent can punish you. So let me show you an example of that here. Yeah, so as you can see there, if Kami blocks the lightning legs, she's able to punish Chun-Li for it. So be careful with this special. Okay, so as you've just seen, if Kami blocks the lightning legs, she can get a full punish from it. So be careful with how you use this special. Don't do the mash input to get it, and in general, don't mash on any kick button, because you'll probably get it by accident. And also to be mentioned, because sometimes I see this a lot in new Chun-Li players, don't use this as a neutral tool. Like, you already have standing hard punch, back medium punch and such to help you in the neutral. Don't keep doing this. That's not good at all. So avoid that, please. Okay, so while the non-EX version of Lightning Legs is unsafe, the EX version is actually safe. So this is one reason to spend the meter on it. So if I'm to do it right next to Kami, you see after she blocks it, she hits me with a jab. But if I do the EX version, you see I'm able to block the jab. So the EX version of Lightning Legs is safe. And another reason to spend the meter on it is that it gives you a knockdown, which the ordinary legs doesn't really do. So if I'm to hit Kami with the Lightning Legs, you see she remains standing with all the non-EX versions. But if I hit her with the EX version, I get more damage and she gets knocked down. So those are the reasons why you would want to use EX Lightning Legs over the non-EX version. Okay, so to summarize how to use Lightning Legs, like I said, don't use it in the neutral and don't mash it out. How I want you to think of this move is as a combo tool. Use this only in combos that you know will hit, because if it's blocked, you get punished. So I'll show you some combos where you can use it later on, but for now, for example, we have this. Yeah, so you see that because I've seen the previous moves in that combo, because I know that they've hit, I'm able to go into the Lightning Legs because I know it will also hit. If Kami blocked the previous moves, you don't do the Lightning Legs. You just let it go, because if she blocks it, just like I showed you before, it'll get punished. So in summary, use Lightning Legs as a combo tool only. Don't use it in the neutral. Don't mash it out. Yeah. Okay, so the next special that I want to look at is her fireball, which is called Kikoken. Okay, now this is a charge move. So you do it by holding back for a bit and then pressing forward in a punch button. Okay, now this is something else that has to be mentioned. This is another pitfall to when you're starting to play Chun-Li. A lot of new players, they literally walk back before pressing forward and punch to throw out the fireball. Now you don't need to do this. The problem with this is that if you're doing it enough, basically you're walking yourself to the corner, so you're giving the opponent an edge over you. So instead of walking back for a while and then doing it, what you can do is press down back as if you're blocking, and then press forward and punch. Now the advantage of doing this is that as I've said, you're pressing both back and down. Now back is for charging the Kikoken, the fireball, and down will charge the spinning bad kick. And as I've already shown you, spinning bad kick, EX spinning bad kick is one of her reliable anti-airs. So you're basically covering two options by doing one thing. And in addition, you're not giving up space. You're not walking yourself to the corner like I just said. So don't do a lot of this to get Kikoken. Just hold your ground, press down and back, charge for a bit, then forward and punch, and you'll always get it. Okay, so now let's look at some of the differences between the versions of her fireball. The light version, it goes the farthest and it moves the slowest. But as you can see, it doesn't go full screen. It stops just short of where Kami is. And as you go up in strengths of the buttons that you use, it travels less distance but faster. So if I had to do the medium version, you see that it went a little faster, but it stops earlier. And this is also true for the hard version. See that? Okay, so now for the EX version, this is the one that actually goes full screen. So, and it hits twice. So if I'm to do the EX version, You see that it travels quite fast and it goes all the way to where Kang is. Another way you can make the fireball go full screen is by using her fast V-trigger. I'll talk a bit about her V-triggers later on, but for now let's just demonstrate this. So you see that it goes all the way to where Kami is. That's the light version. If I'm to do the hard version, the same. Okay, so now let's talk a bit about how to use these fireballs, because they're not like, for example, Guile's sonic booms. You can't just zone with them all day, because for one thing, as you've seen, they don't really go full screen. So one way that they are typically used, actually this is how they are mostly used. You throw one out and then you follow behind it. The reason for this is because the fireball will be covering your approach. Your opponent has to decide how to deal with it as you close space with them. So for example, right here, if I'm full screen and I want to get close to Kami, I can throw out the light fireball and walk behind it. And now I'm close to her. So the purpose behind this obviously is number one, to close the distance. Number two, it's to harass them. So if I throw it again, I can just walk to where I'm in range for my big pose, like standing hard punch. And if they jump, because they see the fireball coming and they're like, oh, she's walking towards me, so let me jump and hit her, you can be ready with your anti-airs. So this is another reason why it's important to get your anti-airs down. It'll help you with this sort of game plan where you're using your fireball to go in against your opponent. While you can do it for a while, I wouldn't recommend trying to zone with this fireball. It's not very effective at that, especially if you're fighting an opponent with a better fireball. Like, you'll never win a fireball war against Guile, so don't even try it. And also Urien, for example. You don't want to just trade fireballs with Urien. I think he comes off better in that war. So unless your opponent, for example, doesn't have a good way of dealing with fireballs, then maybe you can throw some out one after the other. But in general, I would recommend you use it to approach. It's very good at that. It's very good at helping Chun-Li to approach her opponent when she needs to. Okay, lastly, let's look at spinning bird kick. So, as I mentioned with the charging for Kikoken, just hold down and back, charge your down motion for a bit, then press up and kick. Now, as you see, that move, it knocks down, unlike the non-EX lightning legs. So, that's the big advantage of using it in combos versus lightning legs. Now, unfortunately, some of Chun-Li's combos, the optimal ones that end in spinning bird kick, can be quite difficult to do. So you'll need to get in a lot of practice before you're able to do them. Like myself, for example, I couldn't do her BNB, that means her bread and butter combo. I couldn't do it until I hit gold. But don't let that deter you too much, because we actually have a player who made it to Diamond without ever using that combo. So don't let it scare you off playing Chun-Li too much. But just keep it in mind that you'll want to practice how to execute this move in combos before you actually try it in matches. So just to show you the BNB that I'm talking about, this is what it looks like. Yeah, so that's it right there. That's Chun-Li's optimal combo that doesn't use meter. But for now, I'd ask you not to worry about it. It's not very important when you're starting out. Okay, so just like with the non-EX versions of Lightning Legs, I want you to think of the non-EX versions of Spinning Bird Kick as combo enders or as combo tools. This is because they're just as unsafe, if not more so, than the Lightning Legs. So let me show you that in action. Okay, now that we've looked at her specials, and some of them being combo enders, let's take a look at her combo tools normal-wise. Like, what normals do you cancel into either Lightning Legs or Bird Kick to get your combos? So first up is Crouching Light Kick. This is her fastest normal. You can only cancel it into Lightning Legs, nothing else, so keep that in mind. So, a simple combo you can do from this is Crouching Light Kick, Standing Light Punch, and then you cancel into Light Legs. So that looks like this. Okay, now something I should mention before we move on with the rest of the combos is that any combo that ends with any version of Lightning Legs, you can substitute the non-EX version for the EX version if you want to get a knockdown. So with our previous combo, instead of doing Light Legs, let's do EX. Okay, so the next normal we'll look at is Crouching Light Punch, which is this. As I demonstrated earlier, this is the normal from which you get the bread and butter combo, which is this. But like I told you, for now, don't worry about it. So what we'll be doing is substituting the Spinning Bird Kick for Lightning Legs. So the combo is Crouching Light Punch, standing Medium Punch, Crouching Medium Kick into Lightning Legs. So that looks like this. Now keep in mind that with Crouching Medium Kick, which is this, you can cancel it into all versions of Lightning Legs. Next, I want to give you a Crash Counter combo. Now, Crash Counter combos are very important, especially for punishing DPs like Ryu's Shoryuken and such. You know, the invincible moves that we talked about previously. When you block one of these, punish it well, because that will it gives you a lot of benefits to do the Crash Counter combos properly for them. You get a lot of damage and you get some V gauge, which is always good. So what I'll do is that I've set Kami to do her cannon spike after she blocks something from Chun-Li. So what we're going to do is block the cannon spike, and then I'll show you the combo, the Crash Counter combo that you should use at least for now. Okay, yeah, so that's the combo right there, and I'm sure you've noticed that a lot of it is exactly the same as the previous one that I've showed you. So how this combo goes is that after you block the DP, in this case Kami's cannon spike, wait for them to land back onto the ground, hit them with standing hard kick, which is one of Chun-Li's crash counter buttons, then you dash and do the Crouching Light Punch, Standing Medium Punch, Crouching Medium Kick, Legs combo. So let's do that again so that yeah, you can internalize it. So that's all there is to it. Please be mindful of punishing such DPs properly. Because, to be honest, they are done much more often than they should be at the lower ranks. So, if you are able to punish these types of moves properly, you'll be able to climb faster. Okay, now, finally, I want to talk about how to cancel into her super. Now, you can cancel into Chun-Li's super from a lot of moves, but with what we've looked at so far, the most convenient for us will be cancelling it from Lightning Legs. It's not very difficult to do, so it's reliable if you're getting started. So how you do it, since Lightning Legs, you already know it's doing quarter circle forward and kick. All you have to do is input another quarter circle forward and kick right after that. But you have to be quick because it only works on the first two hits of Lightning Legs. So let me show you what that looks like. But first, let's make Kami stop blocking. Yeah. Okay, so here goes. Okay, yeah, so that's it. And now to work it into our combos, we just have to, since Legs is our ender, we just put in what we usually do previously. So from the crouching light kick combo, we can still cancel into super. And we can do just the same thing from the crouching light punch combo. Yeah, so that's it. It's not very difficult to do, but obviously, as with anything, you do need to practice it. Now, I know these combos, I have to make you aware of these. These combos aren't the most optimal things you can do. And as you've seen, I've only given you like three, excluding the ones that cancel into super. The reason for this, I believe that when you're starting out, you really need only three combos, one of which should be a crash counter combo to punish DPs. Otherwise, two other combos will serve you well. The other combos that Chun-Li can do are much better ones that give you more damage, but these three that I've shown you are very good to start with, and you can continue adding to your library of combos as you learn. The worst thing you can do, in my opinion, is to try to overload yourself with information, especially when you're new. So please just practice these combos and get them down. They'll help you a lot. So let me just show them to you one more time, along with the notations, of course, so that you internalize what they look like. Okay, now that I've shown you some basic combos, I think it's a good time to talk about her V-triggers. Because actually, one of her V-triggers does affect her combo potential. So I might have maybe one or two more combos to show you so that you can make use of it properly. So her first V-trigger is called Renkiko. I've already shown you a bit of what it helps her with. The first thing is that it makes her fireballs go full screen, all of them. Another thing is that her medium and hard attacks, they hit twice. Like, you see, this is standing medium punch. Outside this V-trigger, it only hits once, but here it hits twice. So what this does is that a lot of her normals do more damage. So this V-trigger also amplifies her damage. Something else is that it affects her combos. For example, let me just show you this. Crouching light punch, right? We already know that crouching light punch can combo into standing medium punch, but it can't combo into crouching medium kick. So let me disable Kami from doing cannon spike here. Okay, so crouching light punch, standing medium punch, it works. Crouching light punch, crouching medium kick does not work. You see, Kami blocks the crouching medium punch. But if you're in V-trigger 1, you see that now crouching light punch combos into crouching medium kick. So, a simple combo that we can do from this, now that we know that crouching light punch goes into crouching medium kick. We can do crouching light kick, crouching light punch, crouching medium kick into either legs or spinning bird kick. Now with this combo, spinning bird kick is not hard to do, so you can try it out if you want. It's not difficult to execute, so let me show you how it looks with both specials. So that's it. That's another combo that you can put in your belt for when you've activated V-Trigger. V-Trigger 1 at least. Another normal that's really affected by this V-Trigger is her standing hard kick. This is what you remember we used to punish DPs. But let me show you how differently it behaves when you're in V-Trigger 1. So, as previously, we'll block a cannon spike from Kami and then do standing hard kick. You see that Kami, she's popped up into the air. So what does this mean? It means we can't do our combo of dashing in and then doing the crouching light punch combo. It will miss, obviously. So we need an alternative. So this is where I'll introduce you to a new normal that you can use specifically for this purpose. There are other ways you can use it, of course, but for now, keep it to this. The normal I'm talking about is forward hard kick, which is, this normal here. So, if we're punishing a DP and we want really good damage, this is what you do. You block the DP, of course, then you do standing hard kick, forward hard kick, another standing hard kick, then EX lightning legs. So let me show you what that looks like. So if you're out of V-Trigger but you have it available and you block a DP, it's a good idea to activate the trigger as the opponent is coming down so that you're ready with this combo, since as you've seen, it does quite a lot of damage. So that looks like this. And yeah, so this is a good opportunity for you to activate V-Trigger 1. Okay, another normal I can recommend you use during V-Trigger 1 is, it's another new one that we're going to talk about. It's down forward medium kick. That looks like this. Now this move is an overhead, so that means that it can't be blocked crouching. But as you can see, it's a bit slow. Okay, not a bit slow, it's very slow. And out of V-Trigger, it doesn't get you a combo unless it's a counter hit. So outside V-Trigger, it's more often than not worth doing this move. But if you have reason to believe that your opponent won't block it in V-Trigger, it can get you some surprise damage. So as you can see, right there, it combos into crouching light punch. Now something else we know that we've already looked at is that crouching light punch goes into crouching medium kick. So that means that we can do the overhead into crouching light punch into crouching medium kick, and then we do whichever special we want to end with. So with legs, that looks like this. And with spinning bird kick, that looks like this. So depending on which special you are more comfortable with cancelling into, keep this combo in mind for when you notice that your opponent is crouch blocking a lot. Like if they're turtling you, the overhead might surprise them. Okay, so her second V-Trigger is Kikosho. So this makes up for another one of her weaknesses. So we already know that she has good normals with like standing hard punch. But when you hit someone with standing hard punch, like, what do you do next? You know, her big pokes, they don't lead into any meaningful damage. So this is the weakness that Kikosho is supposed to rectify. So when you have it active, for example, let's say with a standing hard punch, we can do something like this. So now we have the ability to combo from our longer ranged pokes, which obviously is a good thing. So if you're interested in using Kikosho, experiment with which normals you can cancel into it. Like, we've already seen standing hard punch works, back medium punch also works. And just have a look around with your normals, see which ones you can work with to convert those pokes that we are talking about into good damage. But something to be careful with, don't be too quick to spend your Kikoshos. I believe you only get 1 on activation and 3 after you activate the V-trigger. So don't just spend them one after the other. You actually have a decent amount of time before the trigger ends. So try to confirm that you've actually hit the opponent so that you can then cancel into the Kikosho. But otherwise, don't just spend them thoughtlessly, like too quickly. Hold on to them for a bit and decide when might be a good time to make use of it. But otherwise, yeah, that's it. This V-trigger, it's easy to understand what it does. Okay, there's one more normal I'd like to talk about. And using it is a bit difficult, but if you can pull it off, it's very useful. And what I'm talking about is this. This is crouching medium punch. Now, be careful with this normal because it's very unsafe, especially really up close. It can be punished very hard. But this normal is very useful because, as you can see, she likes the way she slides along the ground. Her hotbox comes very low, so she's able to avoid some things. So let's see how we can apply that. So I have Ryu here. I've recorded him throwing a fireball. So let's say that your opponent is throwing fireball after fireball after fireball, and you're having a hard time closing the distance. This is one area where this normal can help you. So let's take a look at that. Okay, so he's throwing fireball after fireball after fireball. I'm trying to walk up to him, but it's taking a lot of time and I'm scared to jump. So what do I do instead? I can use crouching medium punch to go under the fireballs. As you can see, I'm getting closer and closer to him. And if I'm close enough, I can actually hit him in retaliation to the fireball. You see that? Okay, now there's something else I want you to notice. Another thing that makes this kind of strategy good. Like, as you can see, he's throwing fireball after fireball, right? But look what happens when, for example, I jump over a fireball and it stays on the screen for a longer time. You see that he can't throw another fireball while the first one is still on the screen. So this also applies to the crouching medium punch. Because I'm not blocking it, it'll be on the screen longer, so he can't just throw another one. You see, a light punch comes out instead. As you can see, it can get a bit difficult to master the timing for this, but if you can do it, it'll help you a lot. So if I'm close enough, I can even stop him from pulling out another fireball. So let's see what this looks like. See that? So if you're able to slide under them, you can interrupt the next one. Yeah, so it's a bit difficult to get this down, but if you can, it'll help you a lot, especially against some characters like Guy. So yeah, practice this. It's good if you can master it. Okay, I think that'll be it for now. We've covered quite a bit about Chun-Li's basic tools and how to use them. So if you're a beginner, this is a good starting point for you. just make sure that you keep practicing everything individually, like adding on to what you already know. Don't try to do everything at once, like don't try to learn everything at once and overload yourself. Just take it a step at a time, even if you have to do the easier things. Like I said, doing the spinning bird kick combos can be a bit difficult, so if you need to, just end your combos with lightning legs. There is nothing wrong with that. You'd rather go for the damage that you are 100% sure to get than the one where it's like 50-50, you might or you might not. So if you need to, use the easier options. And now, as I mentioned at the start of this video, this guide is kind of an introduction done by the Chun-Li Discord. So if you want to learn more, please come visit us. I'll leave a link to the Discord in the description and in the comment section. That way you'll be sure not to miss it. We appreciate anyone coming in. Everyone is friendly. We have some good players who are always happy to help. So if you have anything that you want to ask, and I mean anything, don't think any question is silly or whatever, please come in, ask, and you'll be helped fairly quickly. We have a lot of people who love to help newcomers, so please visit us. Now I'll leave you with some clips of some gameplay with Chun-Li that was done by Ross, as I mentioned before. What I want you to do as you look at them is try to see how he uses his normals, like the pokes that I've been telling you about, standing hard punch and such. See how he uses them, see how he anti-airs and such. Don't focus so much on the fancy things like the combos that he does. Like, he does a lot of the BNB, but don't focus on that. Try to focus instead on the very basics, like how he spaces himself and how he uses his buttons. So yeah, that's going to be it for now. As I said, please visit us in the Discord for more. Thanks so much for watching. I hope to see you again, and good luck in learning Chun-Li. Bye. Fight!